In the previous video, we edited some blocks with the toolbar. At some point, maybe you wondered something like, hey, where are the options to change the colors, or the sizes, or other style-related things? Well, those options are in the block tab of the sidebar, and that is precisely what we will explore in this video. Note that the sidebar options may be different if you're using a different theme. As we previously mentioned, we are using the 2020 theme. Okay, let's start with the paragraph block. The first option in the sidebar allows me to change the text size. The options I have are small, regular, large, and larger. I can see the exact size of each of the options here. Regular is 21 points, and large is 26.5. If I want something in between, I can choose the custom option and type in 22, for example. That's okay. The reset button is here, and I can click it if I want to return the text to its original state, which I want to do, so let's click it. The drop cap option makes the initial letter in the text large. Now, if you look in the sidebar, you will notice that there is no option there to change the color of this letter. That is because its color is based on the settings that apply to the colors of the links, buttons, or featured images across the entire site. Those settings are not here, but in the customizer. Let me quickly show you how that works. I'll first save this draft here. Now, I click the appearance menu item and then choose customizer. Here, I go to the Colors tab and click on Custom. A slider appears now, and I can set the color there. Notice the color of the category at the middle of the screen. As I move the slider, the color changes with it. To save the changes, I click Publish. And then I go back to my post. And now you see that the letter has a slightly different color. Less red, more purple. There are some other color options for the paragraph block here. With them, I can change the background color of the paragraph. For example, if I want to make this first paragraph stand out, I could give it a different background color. I can also click Custom Color and play around with it, or add a precise color value if I know it. The text color can be changed here. And look at this neat option. If the color combination of the background and the text is not legible, WordPress informs me about it. If you need to customize some blocks, you can use the Advanced tab. Of course, you will need to know how to use CSS. You will see the Advanced tab in the sidebar of every block. Let's now move on to the image block. There's plenty I can do with the image in the sidebar. The first option is styles. There are two styles, the default and the circle mask. With the drop-down menu below, I can choose the default style. That means that if I choose the circle option as the default style, whenever I upload an image, it will appear as a circle in every post. From the moment I set it as a default style, onwards, I will have circles for images. Below the Styles tab, we have the Image Settings, and the first option there is the Input box for Alternative Text. There are two main reasons to add alternative text. First, people with visual impairments may use screen readers to access posts and pages. With the alternative text, you could provide those people with a description of the image, which the screen reader then reads to them or displays in Braille. Search engines can also read the alternative text to understand what the image is about. So, by using the alternative text, you improve the accessibility of your site and you can increase your chances of ranking better in the image search. The next settings are about the size. There are four options here: thumbnail, medium, large, and full size. You can also add your custom size in the image dimensions input fields. Finally, with the last size settings, you can change the size in 25% increments. But there's an even easier way to change the image size. See these blue dots at the edges? Click and hold one of them, and then just drag the image to the desired size. Very easy. On we go to the heading block. I already showed you that you can change the heading levels in the toolbar. You can do the same thing here in the sidebar. Maybe this heading could use a new color now. I click on the custom color link. Because I know the exact value of the color I want, I can type it into the input field here. Ooh, that looks nice. Now the heading actually matches Yoast's shirt. Okay, let's change the other headings as well, so they all match. There's another useful setting in the Advanced tab. For this one, you don't need to write any code. The first option here is the HTML anchor. This is what it does. It allows you to link any part of your text to the heading. So, when you click that text, you are taken to where the heading is. Let me show you. I have some text about speakers here. I'll connect the word speakers with the Who Can Apply heading. I select the heading, and in the Advanced tab, I type in speakers in the HTML anchor input field. Now, I go to the word I want to add a link to, which is speakers. I select it, click on the linked chains, and type in hashtag speakers in the input field. The word is now clickable. I need to save the draft and preview it to show you how it works. Here it is. Click, and I'm taken to the heading. I'd say that can be quite useful. Let's go back to the post editing and see what else we have got. We changed the support quote so many times, I guess it's had enough. If I want to change the style again, I can do it here in the sidebar. Besides the Advanced tab, there are no other options here. You may notice, though, that the quote features a vertical line over here. Just like with the large initial letter in the paragraph block earlier, I cannot change the color of the line here, but I can in the customizer, exactly as we did it for the letter. What more do we have? Ah yeah, the list block. The list block only has the advanced option in the sidebar, but all the important editing options for the list are in the toolbar, and we saw them in the previous video. We're almost at the end with one more block to go. The final block that I want to edit is the button. There's lots I can do here. I can start off by changing the style. The two available styles are fill or outline. I like this outline option, but I am worried that it's not eye-catching enough. So I will stay with the fill style. Let me change the background color to a Yoast color in the color settings. Okay, looks good. Now, I can also change the borders of the button with the border settings. As I move the slider, the borders change. I like the way it looks right now. Good, let's just keep it. Finally, since this button takes the user to a different page, I want it to open in a new tab when the reader clicks on it. So I click here to activate the Open in New Tab toggle. There you have it. We edited the post with the options in the sidebar, and now we can go on to publish it. Stick around for the next video, where we'll show you how to publish a post.